Check out this 1 minute design review for a microcontroller module and a baseboard. And because this design consists of two PCBs, we're gonna make this a 2 minute design review. The very first thing I notice is you have ESP32 on your baseboard. Why? In your module, you have a 6-layer stack up and you have a dedicated power plane. Now, if you had done best practices and put everything on the top side, you would have been able to have room on the bottom side for your power routing and some of your internal routing, and that would let you bring this stack up down to 4 layers. I do see some spots that need cleanup in the silkscreen layer and your solder mask layer, which you would know about if you did a DRC check. Hey, check this out, only 4 rule violations, but that's because you have 110 waived violations. And out of those waived violations, you have 30 unrouted net constraint violations. I can tell that your via holes are way too big for that pad size. Size your via pads so that they are 8 mils larger in diameter than your via holes. A proper baseboard is going to use a transceiver rather than an ESP32 for wireless, but at least you put it on the board edge and you have the cutout for ground below the module. But the one thing that you did, which I wouldn't recommend, is you put this pin header right next to the antenna region. You used a coplanar waveguide approach for your USB lines. It really isn't necessary because those vias just take up space for routing on the inner layers. You use some test points to access the USB lines, which is fine, but you do have 0-ohm resistors here. You know you can use those 0-ohm resistors as test points, right? I can see that you're using 80-ohm impedance for the USB lines rather than the standard 90-ohm impedance. You also have these other impedance profiles. None of those other impedances at 44 ohms or 72 ohms can be found on STM32. You also used a power layer in this design. Dedicated power layer really isn't necessary here, but of course, it really isn't gonna hurt anything either. If you wanna send me your multi-board design, send it to me on LinkedIn with your design files or your manufacturing files.